One teen's good deed was worth $10,000. We need help finding this dog a new home, and we take a look into Harriet Tubman's time in New Jersey. Good morning, everybody. I'm Bianca Velasquez, and you're listening to Today in NJ on November 4th. A guy whose fiance lost a $10,000 engagement ring 2 years ago got the surprise of his life this week. 18-year-old Brienne Sinks spotted a 1.2-carat diamond ring in the sand during a beach cleanup with her school at Asbury Park. It's already lucky that the ring was actually found, but even more incredible, Brienne and her mom were able to track down its owner. She spotted the manufacturer's name on the band of the ring, then traced it back to the store in Wall Township, where Tony Silva had bought the ring years ago. Tony was shocked to get a call from the store and happily met Brienne and her mom there. And there is one more surprise, too. Tony did not bring his fiance with him to pick up the ring or even tell her that the ring was found. Instead, he said he's going to surprise her and give her the ring all over again. So I'd love to see that reaction, and kudos to Brienne for finding both the ring and the owner. An adorable Pitbull Terrier mix named Shanice has hit an unfortunate milestone, 1,000 days in a shelter. She was found walking alone around Sayreville all the way back in 2016, and no one has claimed her since. She hasn't been adopted yet because people at the Associated Humane Society in Tinton Falls say she would live best as an only pet. She loves to play, go on walks, she knows how to give paw, and she loves people. And you could take our word for it because video producer Natalie Patterson was covered in doggy kisses by the end of her video shoot. You could check that video out on NJ.com's Facebook page too. The shelter says she'd be a great dog for a family with slightly older children, so we hope that she gets adopted very soon. Ahead of Harriet Tubman's biopic movie hitting theaters last weekend, we looked into her time spent in New Jersey. After escaping her life of slavery, she settled down in Cape May and worked as a cook for 3 summers there. Tubman helped hundreds of slaves get to freedom, including some in New Jersey. New Jersey was home to dozens of stops for the Underground Railroad, according to the New Jersey Historical Commission. Most of them extend in a similar route as the New Jersey Turnpike. Perth Amboy was also important because a quick boat trip across the Arthur Kill would deliver runaways to Staten Island. The banks of the Raritan River in New Brunswick were also significant because that's where runaways needed to cross through on their path. It looks like a really powerful film, and I will personally be going to see it. That's all for today, guys, and as always, thank you for listening to Today in NJ for your morning news. If there's anything you want to hear on this podcast or you just have some suggestions, please send an email to podcasts@njadvancemedia.com. I'm Bianca Velasquez, and I hope you guys have a great start to your week.